Welcome! In this video, we are learning about services in Drupal and the services container, as well as the truth about dependency injection. What are services in Drupal, and why are they important? As a developer, services are used to perform consistent operations, like accessing the database or sending an email. So, for example, rather than use PHP's native MySQL functions to write or read data, we instead use the Drupal core provided database service to perform the operations. In this way, our code can simply access the database without having to concern ourselves about whether the database is MySQL or SQLite or some other database. In fact, the database server could in theory be totally swapped with a different database provider, and as long as our code uses the database service, we wouldn't have to change our code at all. Comparably, when sending an email, the mechanism for sending an email could be SMTP, or it could be some other method such as an API call to an external mail service. But our code just needs to simply tell Drupal's email service to send an email. This service abstraction is also very beneficial for testing code. By leveraging PHPUnit tests, it is easier to test the actual business logic of the code separate from the service implementation. The moment you start Drupal, it already contains many services. These are like tools, waiting for you to take advantage of them. Here's the truth. A service is a useful object. A service is a class that you or someone else creates that does some work for you. In Drupal speak, a service is any object managed by the service container. The service container is also called the dependency injection container. Use that term if you want to. But seriously though, in Drupal and in Symfony, there is a single object called the global container. It's basically an associative array of services. A service corresponds to exactly one class. The service container is very important as it contains the available services. It knows about their relations and configurations, and it even constructs them. In fact, the global service container holds every useful object in the system, and each service has a name. When you need to get access to a service so you can use it to do some work for you, say the email validator, you just say, "Dear core services container, can I please get the service by the name of email.validator?" Easy peasy. It gets better. Everything that Drupal does is actually done by one of the services in the container. The reading of configuration, the execution of the routing, the handling of the cache, registering themes and modules, logging errors, reading and writing from the database. These are all done by various services, and you have access to them all. You can use these services at any time. You can even override and replace any core service you want to, or you can create your own. Fabulous. The exact list of Drupal-provided services is obviously going to evolve over time. At the moment of this recording, there are 407 services available. Take some time to grasp the diversity of services and the scope of what is available. Some important services are the database service, the plugin manager, the logger, the translation service, and the service to provide a proxy to the current user. Visit the list of core services to encounter them all. You can use the Drupal service method to retrieve any defined service by its name. It is meant to be used for services which do not have a dedicated service described on the next slide. So for example, let's access the date service using the generic Drupal :: service method. The name of the date service is date.formatter. This code provides a service to handle the various date-related functionality. Likewise, to obtain the email validator service, we again use the generic Drupal :: service method with the following code. The argument for the Drupal :: service method is the machine name of the service. How to use each specific service and its available methods are detailed in its respective documentation page. So, for example, the date formatter service can be found at the link provided. As we recently learned, we can obtain an object to any service by using the generic Drupal service method. It turns out, though, that some services are so commonly used, there is a global Drupal class that provides static methods to access these most common services. These static methods are found by examining the Drupal class documentation. A link is provided which lists these dedicated services. So, for example, /Drupal:\database will return the database service, or /Drupal:\translation will return the string translation service. Awesome. Roughly speaking, there are around 50 dedicated static methods to access these commonly used services. You can encounter the full list at the link given. Remember to modify the URL depending on which specific version of Drupal you are using. As Drupal core embraces and evolves into a more object-oriented code base, you should strive to minimize the use of both the general service method and global Drupal static methods. As a rule of thumb, if you are working within a hook function, it is okay to use those service methods. In general, though, really try to develop the functionality you need using object-oriented approaches, as this is the direction Drupal is headed. Whether you implement a class, or an interface, or a form, in nearly all cases, you can and should inject the service you will eventually use. This process is called dependency injection. Let's learn about that now. Dependency injection is the preferred method for accessing and using services in Drupal. It's not as scary as it sounds. It should be used whenever possible. Here's how. Rather than calling out the global services container, instead, services are passed as arguments to a constructor. So, for instance, what if you need to access the database service from within your class? No problem. Rather than using the global services method, instead, create an __construct method with a connection argument that has the connection type hint. Let's examine some sample code which achieves this. Notice that because we are using a database connection, we must include the database connection class, which we do on line 5. Within the dependency injection example class, on line 15, is the protected property of the DB connection. We will eventually set this to an object containing the database connection service. Setting the DB connection property occurs with __construct magic method on line 24. Examine the connection service argument of the constructor on line 23. This argument is type hinted with the connection type. And further, this argument is annotated in the doc block of the constructor on line 20. So this is dependency injection in a nutshell. The constructor of the class receives objects it depends on as arguments. It's that simple. Dependency injection is a technique in which an object receives other objects that it depends on. With this example code, the Drupal container automatically knows to pass the database service when instantiating the dependency injection example class. We will cover creating custom services in detail later in this course. For now, just know that Drupal services are defined in the implementing module's services.yaml file. Excellent effort in gaining more essential knowledge for Drupal module development. In this lesson, we got familiar with Drupal services and why they are important. We learned the truth that a service is simply a useful object. We learned various approaches to obtain the services we need to use through the services method, the global static methods, and dependency injection. We recognize that because Drupal is becoming more object-oriented, we should strive to use dependency injection in obtaining our services. However, we acknowledge that this is not always possible, particularly when developing within the scope of legacy Drupal hook functions. We also briefly discussed that in order to create custom services, we must declare them in a services.yaml file within our module directory. Going forward, using services and dependency injection will become more and more intuitive. For now, get familiar with the various Drupal services which are available and are quite powerful. As always, you are encouraged to take time and examine the resources provided. That's all for now. Happy learning.